Being called a bottom feeder doesn't bother this guy. People have only been saying it for 200 million years. Shovelnose sturgeon may be the most unique fish species in Wyoming, and along the Bighorn River, populations of this species got a boost in numbers this fall with the stocking of over 11,000 juvenile sturgeon. Statewide fisheries biologist Nick Hoberg says these 7-inch stockables were spawned at the Garrison National Fish Hatchery in North Dakota, the offspring of broodfish collected in the Yellowstone and Powder Rivers in Montana.
What we're doing is releasing our fish for the year that are part of our restoration effort to reestablish shovelnose sturgeon through this portion of the Bighorn River. Shovelnose sturgeon grow pretty quickly early in their life, and they're a very long-lived species, so these fish being about 7 inches now, they won't be easily caught for another couple years probably until they, you know, reach a foot long or more.
Some will live here long after that, perhaps up to 20 years. Shovelnose sturgeon is considered a species of greatest conservation need in Wyoming. It was reintroduced to the Bighorn River in 1996, with stocking efforts ongoing since then to create a unique sport fishing opportunity for anglers. And over the years, nearly 600,000 fingerling and fry sturgeons have been stocked in the Bighorn River.
All indications are that we have, you know, adult fish. We've been stocking for nearly 20 years now, and many of those cohorts are now large adults that are beginning to try to spawn. And so all indications are that the fish we're putting in the river are growing quite well and reaching maturity.
Shovelnose sturgeon are notable for these bony plates along their body called scutes. Before being loaded into the stocking truck, each fish had one of these scutes removed from their body. These batch markings will be done on each fish stocked through 2020, so when biologists do future netting surveys, they can tell which fish came from a hatchery, the age class, and when it was stocked. Fish without the markings give biologists a better idea of the level of wild reproduction taking place and if the population is able to have viable offspring on its own. 17 larger fish, brood culls from the same hatchery, were given pit tags under their skin so biologists can track their movements along the river and which habitats they frequent. Another characteristic of sturgeon are the whisker-like barbels next to its mouth that act as sensors on the river bottom to identify prey. The sucker-type mouth sucks up the prey, usually aquatic invertebrates. This unique fish provides anglers with something different to catch in Wyoming and are quite tasty. In Wyoming, the statewide regulation is 2 in possession. This is Ray Hageman with the Wyoming Game and Fish Department.